So it really means that these are up and running. So what I'm going to do is to become the root for a moment, going to opt. Now if you see at the moment, obviously we've got Qt going to Qt 5.15.2. What I'm going to do is rename the Qt version 5 directory, or Qt 5 version directory, and call it Qt 5.12 Qt 5, something like old maybe. Now what that means now, event any new packages which need Qt 5, which effectively is only really Falkon, but there could be other ones, won't be able to load or access the programs, because obviously the symlink is pointing in the wrong place and all the paths point at the symlink. So any libraries that are currently loaded in use will still remain in memory, and that's why I'm hoping that this won't affect Falkon while I've got it open. So all I need to do now is to go through these options but just tweak things slightly differently. So for example, this, let's have a look at this prefix. It doesn't exist because it's only used for building. So I'm going to set this up again so that we install it actually in OptQt5, but OptQt5 actually points at our, what will be our new directory and what was the old version of Qt. And it says here sometimes, you know, we've already read this, so all we need to do is run this makedir. We don't need to do create the link again. Sudo. Now if I look at the opt, you'll see the link is not read anymore because it's now valid, but obviously it's pointing at an empty directory. Qt5/opt/qt5, right. And if I actually look inside the link, there you can see it's an empty directory. QCA, if it's been installed or you're installing or updating this package, then QCA needs to be reinstalled. I don't think we've done that one. Right, yeah, see this, I can't open this link in a private window now because the Falkon hasn't got access to libraries, but I can still switch the tabs. So what I shall do is on a browser on my system that I'm recording with, I'll just look that up and find out what chapter it's in. So QCA. Because I don't think we've done this one. So it's in Chapter 9, General Utilities. Chapter 9. No, we haven't done that, so we haven't got to worry about reinstalling that. So that's good. If Qt5 has been reinstalled into the same directory as an existing instance, run the commands done by root, such as make install from console or non-Qt5 window manager. Otherwise, may overwrite libraries that are in use, that should not be in use. So as I say, I'm installing a fresh directory, and the reason is I want to see how much of a difference there is between the Qt5 that I installed with the minimal number of system packages and the Qt5 I'm about to install with all the dependent packages in place. So I'm in theory, I think it should be smaller because it's got less to build for itself, because we've got stuff already in the system that it can use. The build time and space required for the full Qt5 is quite long. The instructions below do not build the tutorials and examples. Removing the Gnome make. So unless you're particularly interested in them, just leave that as it is. And it's the same thing there about installing the Qt5 hierarchy, which we're not doing. So let's expand Qt5. Yeah, it's that one there. Right, that's expanded. It shows how big it is, the amount of time it took to expand. So Qt everywhere. Run this patch in. Fix some issues with these sub commands. Make sure that's copied completely. And then, first of all, what we'll do is just run an ldconfig, make sure all the libraries we've got have been installed and are actually in the cache. Call this up, let's look at the options. So, confirm license, open source, no make examples. System SQLite, that's okay. DBus linked, OpenSSL linked. Syslog, skip web engine. And switch enables the system version of Halfbuzz. So let's add that. Oh, it's got that in as well. So it doesn't look like there's anything particularly extra to add in there. So maybe this package wouldn't have been much difference in terms of system libraries. Well, I do seem to remember I had to disable some things, maybe like the Halfbuzz, I can't remember now. And this one takes a little while as well, I seem to remember. Okay, let's have a quick look at the summary. Well, there's quite a lot to look there actually. It's got glib, it's got ICU. Just looking at all the nodes to see if there's anything there that should be activated that hasn't been activated. But it's looking all okay. So it's found MySQL, i.e. MariaDB, SQLite, ODBC we built as well. So it's got those. Obviously it hasn't got PostgreSQL, didn't build that. So GStreamer has found version 1.0, which is the newer of the two there. So it all looks good. Let's just read this now. Okay. So it actually says, this one I want to check, Qt will be installed into opt Qt5, which is good. So I'm going to now build this and wait for it to complete. Okay, so that's finished compiling, or compiled successfully. I'm going to install it now. So this should go into the new directory. Okay, that's installed. So we can have a quick look at the Opt Qt5 directory. It should now have stuff in there, which it does. And if I did a dmssh to see the size of it, that's 259. And the old one, well, obviously it's got Qt Web Engine in it as well, but the old one, you can see it's 407 at the moment, so I'll be interested to see what it actually jumps up to after Qt Web Engine has been installed. So I'm going to become root, it's got a few other things to do. First thing I've got to do is move these references. And then this says that I haven't messed anything up there. I didn't ensure that the Qt5 prefix existed, so that's why those errors have come up. So if I do sudo minus e su, Qt5 prefix should exist now. And if I rerun that command, it should run without failure. I just hope it hasn't messed anything else up. If there's any, yeah, it's worked now. If there's any other file called .prl. I wanted to check this Qt5 binder existed, which it doesn't, looks of it. So it gets defined here. The only reason I check it is because it says that if you've changed it, obviously we've not done that. So, although this is probably not changed, I'll do it anyway in case the installation's actually deleted older files. No harm in doing that. Do that as well. Configuration. Now these shouldn't need changing because they're part of BLFS rather than the Qt5 package. So what we'll probably do best of all is to just view them. And you can actually see there's more in there than what is being pasted in here. That could be the Qt web engine stuff that's actually being modified. Have a look at that and check. No, there's nothing there. So in that case, it means that Qt has installed its own version. Oh no, it hasn't. Oh, this is Qt5. This is probably something that we've done elsewhere. So this is why it's best to check rather than just blindly overwrite some things. So you can see it's doing effectively the same thing. This is the if you installed it in user, so we'll skip past that one. Right, yes, that's why it looks different. It's because that's the Qt5sh file for when Qt5 is in ops. You can see there's no changes there. And we need to check the ldso.conf file because by default it would check under user, but we haven't installed it there, so that's why it has to be added in manually. And you can see it's there, opt qt5 lib. So that's all okay. So that's completed qt5. I'm not going to shut this tab down in case it causes an error or crashes Falkon, because remember, although we've got part of the new Qt5 libraries installed, we've still got Qt Web Engine missing, and obviously it's one of the dependencies of Falkon. Is the direct dependency actually. So I'm going to tidy this up now. And I'm going to mark that off as complete now. Qt5.